I'm Jason, and this is my Travelogue. And this is Austin. Here we are at the Museum of the Weird with King Kong and Marti Motormouth and all sorts of other fun adventures on 6th Street that you'd only find here in Austin. Of course, there it is. Ta-da. But it's 6th Street, so you never know what's going to happen.
Oh, my name is Steve Busti. I'm the owner of the Museum of the Weird here in Austin, Texas.
Yeah.
And we've been in business since 2005. A lot of the stuff that's in the museum now used to be for sale in the store.
Okay.
And I sold a lot of really cool stuff before I, you know, realized, man, I'm never going to see that again, you know?
Sure.
This building is primarily used for us sideshow performers, so we could do our amazing acts.
Where do you perform your show?
In here.
Oh, okay.
This is usually where I perform, but this is also where the lizards hang out as well.
Oh,
we have Chloe on top, Alvin in the middle. There you go.
That's Torgo right there.
She is Torgo, our 6'9" monitor lizard. We've had her for about 13 years.
Right beneath King Kong.
Very appropriate, right?
Absolutely. And there's tiki statues all around, and then giant King Kong. Okay, awesome.
Yep, and this is where we do our sideshow as well. And my name is Marti Motormouth, and I do something called the Human Pain Proof Act. So if you'd like to see
the yeah. Sure. Why not, right?
Right? It's the best thing ever.
When in Austin, when you came all the way from Seattle just to see it, you
got to see an amazing sideshow.
Oh, fabulous.
Pretty cool stuff. But one act that I like to do, though, is something with a human bear claw. As you can see, that is a real bear trap, or a raccoon trap. You can't open it with the grip of your hand.
Uh-huh.
In order to open something like this, you actually have to use the whole entire weight of your body
right. To
unleash it. So, you know, you have your bear trap set like that, and you know, a little furry animal comes along, and bam, it's on there pretty well. You can see that as a standard hammer.
That's not kidding around.
Now, the way that I'm going to do this is that I'm going to put my hand in here, hopefully not breaking my hands or my fingers. Everybody ready?
Hey, we're ready.
Awesome. I like how you're not trying to stop me. No, I'm kidding. Okay. I'm not going to look. There's that bear right there.
Well,
isn't that bear clap? If you want to give it a good tug on there, sir, make sure it's on there.
Oh, yeah, that's...
Yep, you can see how twisted my fingers are up in there. My bones are just pretty legit on there.
Rubber, I guess.
This next act is the human blockhead. I don't know if you've ever seen it,
No.
But you have to be a real blockhead to do this.
All right.
In order for you to do this, it just requires a good old nail and a hammer. I want you to make sure that nail is real for me, sir.
Folks, this is a very real nail. There's no doubt.
Very thick nail.
Yeah.
So essentially what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this in my nose, hopefully until there's no more nail, until the lights go out, okay? Okay, it is in there pretty well.
Yes.
You can see that right there.
It's a handsome, yeah, a handsome devil with
it. Thank you. Thank you very much. And now I need a volunteer in order to take this out. So I'm going to use your hand, your other hand, while you're not recording.
Absolutely, yes.
And you know what you're going to do is just hold on to the tip, and I'm going to pull my head back, okay?
All right.
Got it?
Got it.
Thank you very much.
Okay. Wow.
So there's that for you right there, sir. My two lovely acts here at the museum.
That was fantastic.
Thank you.
Some Big Red at the old Ironworks BBQ. Let's hear from Mr. Roland, and he can tell us a little bit about what makes this place so great. Cool.
Roland, why is Ironworks the best barbecue in Austin? Because I came all the way from Seattle to get it for a friend.
Seattle. Wow. Well, we've been, you know, we feel like we're the best. We've been around 34 years. This summer will be 34 years.
Yeah.
We have original recipes, the same owners. We've changed hardly anything.
Is that right?
Kind of kept the same recipes. And we have some loyal customers. It's not just the barbecue, it's the whole environment, the whole family experience.
Yeah. What's your favorite out of all the things you guys do?
I'd say the beef ribs are probably my favorite. But everything is really good. We have some really good baby back ribs, really good chicken on the bone, some really good, excellent pork loin. Well, it's a good big variety, not just necessarily shooting for one item.
Good to be here. It's good to be in Austin.
Thank you.
Enjoying some of this stuff. All right, cool.
Oh, this is one of the stipulations of me and Mike's relationship. This is what our relationship hinges on, one of the things, is he catches the cockroaches, and I do not. And this is the official cockroach cup. You don't know what cockroaches are?
No, I know what they are, but why?
Okay, well, so in Texas, freaking these beasts are huge.
They're about as big as the cup.
Like, no joke, including antlers.
Antlers? They've got a red nose.
I know! They're like what? Like, legit, like that big? They're so big, you can hear them when they run, and they like run into the wall. You can hear it. That's how huge
you can hear them
they are.
On the carpet.
Yeah.
They're inside the house?
Oh, okay.
How do they get?
This is Texas, dude. They're freaking everywhere.
I didn't know that.